character. Am I a guy or a girl in this game? Oh god. Izzy! Yeah, so are you a guy in this game? Guy, I think. Okay. Huh. Okay. I have a name. History. What? I see an annoying girl running towards me from the distance, waving her arms in the air. Hey, Vidlim! How's it going? That girl is Sayori, my neighbor and good friend since we were children. Oh my god. You know the kind of friend. There's actually a character? Well, where am I supposed to put that? Oh, okay, my bad. Oh shoot, wrong thing. Not this. My camera, yes, this thing. Like that? My floaty head thing? Okay, there we go. See the magic of the floating head? Okay. You know the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it just kind of works out because you've known each other for so long. Do I actually have to read this out loud? But she's going to chase after me like this, I almost feel better off running away. Our defiant idol in front of the crossfit and let her catch up. Let's say already. Look at those eyes! I overslept again! But I caught you! I can do that too, anime character! Jeez. Oh, I like that emoticon. That's so cute. Okay, it seriously looks cuter on the anime character. If people stare at you for acting weird, then I don't want them to think we're a couple. Fine. But you did wait for me. We cross the street together and make our way to school. Oh my god. On a club? Let's join the swim club. Did I? I'm sure it's possible that I did in one of our many conversations where I dismissively go along with whatever she's going on about. Sayori likes to worry a little too much about me when I'm perfectly content just getting by on the average while spending my free time on games and anime. I was talking about how I'm worried that you won't learn to socialize. Your happiness is really important to me, you know? And I know you're happy now. But I'd die at the thought of you becoming a neat? Yeah, let's go look at a club. Come on. I'll totally try. Don't you worry about that. Yay! Te pelo. I like the coffee one. They're so cute. Motivation. Oh god, there's so much reading. Clubs. Sayori wants me to check out some clubs. I guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club. What? go away. Exactly, see? My dog agrees. Go away. You know what? Oh, that you could come to my club. Get them all? Do we get to kill people in this game? Now she's vice president. I said my interest in lit is literature is guaranteed to lit. I gotta delete people. Oh my god. You make literature? Yeah, let's go get a cupcake. This today marks the day I sold my soul for a cupcake. I like it. I love it. I'd sell my soul for a cupcake. Maybe two. Everyone, the new member is here. I told you, don't call me a new member. Cupcakes! Exactly. I don't trust you. Welcome to the club. It's a pleasure to meet you. You brought a boy? Way to kill the atmosphere. Oh, she's cute. Well, hello. Welcome, welcome. Well, she's got pretty green eyes. This club is full of incredibly cute girls. What are you looking at? If you want to say something, say it. So sorry. That's gay. Her small figure makes me think she's probably a first year. She's also the one who made the cupcakes. Ignore her. Yuri? Okay. Monica. Ah, so this is Monica. Okay. Completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little... Oh, God. Look at her. Come sit down, Bella. We made the room for you at the table. I'll get the cupcakes! Somebody get me a cupcake! Me too, me too. Who's Sayori? I already forgot. Oh, I don't want to sit near her. Ta-da! Ooh, wah! Show me, show me, show me! I want to see the cupcake! Oh god, these anime things. I like the color of her hair. The purple is really nice. I believe you. Oh my god, there's so much reading. Tea and reading might not be a pastime for me, but at least I enjoy tea. I'm glad. What made you consider the literature club? I didn't. When do I get to make choices? Oh, she's the president? Okay. I I probably should pay attention, right? I'm surprised. How come you decide to start your own club? You could probably be a board member of any of the major clubs. Weren't you a leader of the debate club last year? Well, you know, to be honest, I can't stand all of the politics. Oh my god, no freaking doubt. I'm zoning out just reading it. Okay, so she's a great leader. Good job.
The literature.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's grow this club and make it amazing. And eat cupcakes every day and get super fat. Let's do it. I like scary books. Manga. Yes! Fantasy books. Ooh, I like fantasy books. Oh my god. I like a lot of things. Okay. Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well. I don't trust you. Gentle. She's a psychopath, probably. I hate horror. Why? Why? Oh, God. Oh, she was writing a poem? Cute. I wish my eyes could do that. That's the one thing I like about anime. I wish my eyes could do that. That facial expression. I want to read everyone's poems. Okay. I have an idea. We're going to go do something now. What? I didn't agree to write a poll. Let's do it! Uh-oh. Don't make them psycho. Yeah! And now it's time to run away. Welcome to the Literature Club.
Good job.
Everyone, remember tonight's assignment.
Write a poem. Okay.
Oh, really? How long until something happens? Spoilers. All right. Oh dear God, it's time to write a poem. Pick words you think your favorite club member will like. Something good will happen with whoever likes your poem the most. Okay. Inferno. Disoriented. What? Why would you put suicide in there? Destiny. This poem is gonna be like really, really weird. Okay. Tragedy. Melancholy. Doki doki. Gameplay is, okay. Now, what kind of poem is gonna come up with all these weird things that I just chose? Hi again, Bellamy. Glad to see you didn't run away. Oh, great. Nah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but at least I kept my word. I'm back at the Literature Club. I was the last to come in, so everyone else is already hanging out. Thanks for keeping your promise, Bellamy. I think this would count, yes. Very much. I wrote like an amazing poem for you. Now let's go to the restaurant or something. Calm down there, little guy. Little girl. Jeez. Manga is literature. Cooking, cleaning, how dependable. No, we're not friends. Just saying. Oh, what's this? What is it? Ugh. Never mind. Sarah made it sound like a big deal when it's really not. What do I do? Yeah, I'm sorry, Yuri. I wasn't thinking. I guess that means it's up to me to rescue this situation. Hey, don't worry about it. First of all, I wasn't expecting anything in the first place. So any nice gesture from you is a pleasant surprise. It'll make me happy no matter what. Is that so? Yeah, I won't make a big deal if you don't want it to be. Alright. Look here. She pulls out a bag and pulls out a butcher knife! I didn't want you to feel left out. I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted.
Oh! Is she trying to temptation me?
This is... How's this girl accent?
Pulls out what? She totally pulled out a butcher knife.
Now that everyone's settled in, I expected Monica to kick off scheduled activities for the club, but that doesn't seem to be the case. Sayori and Monica are having a cheery conversation in the corner.
Yeah, I want to see my poem.
I'm really curious to talk to Yuri a little bit more, but at the same time I feel bad for distracting them from reading.
Oh, her. Oh, my bad.
I catch a glimpse of the cover of her book. It looks like the same book that she lent to me. More than that, she seems to be on the first few pages.
Ah, crap.
I think she noticed me looking at her. She sneaks another glance at me and her eyes meet for a split second. But that only makes her hide her face deeper in her book. Sorry. I was just spacing out. I mutter this, sensing I made her uncomfortable.
Oh? It's fine.
If I was focused, then I probably wouldn't have noticed in the first place. But I'm just rereading a bit of this, so...
Loki? Come on, Loki, we're playing Doki Doki.
Okay.
You ready? We're gonna play Doki Doki. Okay. Position game. Get your position.
Let's go.
Sit down.
That's the book you gave me, right?
I wanted to reread some of it.
Oh, you have no head again.
Put your head here.
Yeah, he's joining for Doki Doki time. So we're gonna change it to Loki Loki time.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, focus. We're reading, okay?
Not for any particular reason. Just curious how come.
Puppy! Puppy!
You have two copies of the same book.
Ah!
But when I stopped at the bookstore yesterday, that's not what I meant.
Oh, really? He's kind of chunky, too.
Will you stop moving?
Position yourself so you can... There, go like this.
Okay. I mean, I just happened to buy two of them.
I see. There's something fairly obvious here that Yuri wasn't telling me, but I decided to let it go.
What? 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 We're playing a game, okay?
I'll definitely start reading it soon.
I'm glad to hear.
Once it starts to pick up, you might have a hard time putting it down.
Yeah, if I move my hand, you're gonna fall.
It's a very engaging and relatable story.
Ooh.
Is that so? Okay, lay down. What's it about anyway?
Good job.
Uh-oh. I don't know spoilers on this one, so aw. Nothing better happened to a dog.
Well, Yuri closes the book and scans her eyes over the back. The book is titled Portrait of Markov.
There's an ominous-looking eye symbol on the front.
Alright. I just want to make sure I don't accidentally give anything away. Basically, it's about this girl in high school who moves in with her long-lost younger sister. But as soon as she does, her life gets really strange. She gets targeted by these people who escaped from a human experiment prison, And while her life is in danger, she needs to desperately choose who to trust. No matter what she does, she ends up destroying most of her relationships and her life starts to fall apart. That's kind of dark, isn't it? Yuri made it sound like it was going to be a nice story, so that dark turn came from nowhere. Aha! Aha! Yuri giggles all of a sudden. Ow! Are you not a fan of that sort of thing, Bellamy? No, it's not that. I mean, I could definitely... It's like she's sort of hinting that weird stuff is about to happen, eh? I could definitely enjoy these kind of stories, so don't worry. I hope so. Yeah, I totally forgot that Yuri is into those things. She's so shy and reclusive on the outside, but her mind seems to be completely different. Yeah, she's a psychopath! But okay, it's just those kind of stories. They challenge you to look at life from a strange, new perspective. When horrible things happen, not just because someone wants to be evil, but because they have their own goals or their own philosophy that they believe in. Okay, there's totally something wrong with her. And suddenly, when you thought you related to the protagonist, they're made out to be the naive one for letting their one side of morals interfere with the villain's plans. I'm rambling, aren't I? Not again. I'm sorry. Hey, don't apologize. I haven't lost interest or anything.
Well, I guess it's alright then.
But I feel like I should let you know that I have this problem. When I let things like books and writings fill my thoughts, I kind of forget to pay attention to other people. So I'm sorry if I end up saying something strange. And please, stop me if I start talking too much. I really don't think you need to worry. That just means you're passionate about reading. The least I can do is listen. It's a literature club after all.
That's true.
In fact, I might as well get started reading it, right?
You don't have to.
Aha, what are you saying? Aha! Just a moment ago, you said you were looking forward to it. Let me just get the book. I quickly retrieve the book that I put into my bag. Alright, it's fine if I sit here, right? I slip into the seat next to Yuri's.
Yeah.
Are you sure? What? Hey?
Are you sure?
Yeah. You seem a little apprehensive.
I'm sorry. It's not that I don't want you to. It's just something I'm not very used to.
Why does it make it sound so dirty? Like, I'm just sitting beside her.
That is, reading in company with someone.
My God.
I see.
Well, just tell me if I end up distracting you or anything.
Alright.
Like, seriously. I open the book and I start the prologue. I soon understand what Yuri means about reading in company. It's as if I could feel her presence over my shoulder as I read. It's not a particularly bad thing. Maybe a little distracting, but the feeling is somewhat comforting. Yuri is in the corner of my eye. I realize that she's not actually looking at her own book. I glance over. It looks like she's reading from my book instead.
I'm so sorry. I was just...
Yuri, you really apologize. She's totally a liar. You really apologize a lot, don't you?
I do. I don't really mean to.
Look at that shifty face. Like, don't trust her.
Sorry. I mean,
Here, this should work, right? I slide my desk until it's against Yuri's, then hold my book more between the two of them.
I suppose so.
Yuri timidly closes her own copy. Once we lean in a little bit, our shoulders are almost touching. Whoa. It feels like my left arm is in the way, so instead I use my right hand to hold the book open. I guess that makes it kind of difficult to turn the page.
Yeah.
Yuri takes her left arm and holds the left side of the book open with between her thumb and forefinger. I do the same with my arm on the right hand side of the book. That way, I turn a page and Yuri slides it in her thumb after it flips to the other side. Ow! Okay, go on the floor.
Go.
Be a good boy. But in holding it like this, we're huddled even closer together than before. It's actually kind of distracting me. It's as if I can feel the warmth of Yuri's face and she's in the corner of my vision. Are you ready? Gotcha, go out. Yeah, exactly. Other style music is gonna start soon there. To turn the page. I think I got a bit distracted for a second.
I glance over at Yuri's face again and our eyes meet. I don't know how I'll be able to keep up with her.
This game.
That's okay. You're not as used to reading, right? I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer. It's probably the least I can do, since you've been so patient with me.
Yeah.
Thanks. We continue reading. Yuri no longer asks me if I'm ready to turn the page. Instead, I just assume that she finishes the page before me, so I turn it by my own volition. We continue the first chapter in silence. Even so, turning each page almost feels like an intimate exchange. My thumb gently letting go of the page, letting it flutter over to her side as she catches it under her own thumb.
Oh my god.
Hey Yuri, this might be a silly thought, but the main character kind of reminds me of you a little bit.
You think so?
How does she... Well, I guess she's more blunt in a lot of ways, but she also second-guesses all the things that she says and does. Like, she's afraid she'll do something wrong. It's not like I can see into your head or anything, but they're kind of reminiscent of some of your mannerisms.
I see.
Yuri remains silent for a moment. Oh, I agree on the killing part, yes.
But Bellamy, that's probably a terrible thing to have in common with her. That's so embarrassing that you think that.
Wait,
I didn't mean it in a bad way or anything.
Oh god, that scared me. And this is not even a scary game.
Oh my god.
Wait. Oh, Nolan, thanks for the follow. How's it going?
Sorry, I really didn't know you were self-conscious about that sort of thing. I guess I more meant that it's kind of cute.
Ah, what are you saying all of a sudden? Okay, everyone. I think it's about time we share today's- Yes, finally! We can see my horrible poem that I made.
We might not have enough time if we wait too long.
Ah, Yuri exhales, spared from finishing her thought. Is that all right, Yuri?
You look kind of down. I'm sorry if you haven't been looking forward to this.
It's not. It's fine. Yuri releases her hand from the book, causing it to close on top of my thumb. Alright. I guess I'll do some more reading tonight. Or would you prefer I only read it with you?
I guess I don't have too much of a preference either way.
In that case, I'll read a little more tonight. It'll be more fun to read with you after it picks up a bit, you know?
That's good reasoning. In that case, feel free to finish the first two chapters in your own time.
All right. I stand up. I make a mental note of where I left off in the book, then slip it back into my bag.
By the way, did you remember to write a poem last night?
Yeah. My relaxation ends. Oh god. Here it goes. I can't believe I agreed to do something so embarrassing. I couldn't really find much inspiration since I've never really done this before.
Well, now that everyone's ready, why don't you find someone to share it with?
I can't wait. Sayori and Monica enthusiastically pull out their poems. Sayori's is on a wrinkled sheet of loose leaf torn from a spiral notebook. On the other hand, Monica wrote hers in a composition notebook. I can hardly see Monica's pristine handwriting from where I sit. Natsuki and Yuri reluctantly comply as well, reaching into their bags. I do the same myself. Who should I show my poem to first? Yuri! Yuri seems the most experienced, so I should start with her. I can trust her opinion to be fair. As Yuri reads the poem, I notice her eyes lighten.
Exceptional!
Eh? What was that? Did I say that out loud? Is she? Yuri first covers her mouth, but then ends up covering her whole face.
He's going to hate me.
You really didn't do anything wrong, Yuri. Eh?
I guess you're right. What am I getting nervous for?
Ha 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 ha. Yuri takes a breath.
So, what kind of writing experience do you have?
Your use of imagery and metaphors indicates you've written a lot of poetry before. Really? Wow, that's a huge compliment coming from you. This is actually my first time, really.
Huh?
Yuri stares at me blankly, then looks at my poem again. Well, I know that. I just meant, Yuri trails off, unable to find an excuse. She traces her finger along the words of the poem as if breaking it down more thoroughly. Yeah. Okay. This is the reason I was able to tell. It's just that there are specific writing habits that are usually typical of new writers. And having been through that myself, I kind of learned to pick up on them. I think the most noticeable thing I recognize in new writers is that they try to make their style very deliberate. In other words, they tend to pick up a writing style separate from the topic matter and they form-fit the two together. The end result is that both the style and the expressiveness are weakened. Once Yuri finds her train of thought, it's as if her demeanor totally changes. Her stammering is completely gone and she sounds like an expert. Of course, that's not something you can be blamed for. There are so many different skills and techniques that go into writing even a simple poem. Not just finding them and building them, but getting them to work together is probably the most challenging part. It might take you some time, but it all comes with practice and learning by example and trying new things. I also hope that everyone else in the club gives you valuable feedback. Natsuki can be a little bit biased, though. Biased how? Never mind. I shouldn't be talking to people like that. Sorry. It's fine. I'm not sure if Yuri's apologizing to herself, to me, or to Natsuki. Do you mind if I read your poem now? Please do. I'd love to share my thought process behind it. Yuri smiles dreamily as if that's a rare opportunity for her, which itself is kind of funny. After all, isn't this supposed to be a literature club? Oh god. Ghost under the light. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow. Bathing. It must be this one. The last remaining streetlight to have withstood the test of time. The last yet to be replaced by the sickening blue-green hue of the future. I bathe. Calm. Breathing air of the present, but living in the past. The light flickers. I flicker back. I'm sorry I have such terrible handwriting. What? I wasn't thinking that at all. But it took you a long time to read. I don't read script very often. I actually think your handwriting is pretty.
Eh?
That's a relief. Also, I liked the poem. Even though it's short, it was really descriptive. It wasn't too short? I usually write longer poems. Not at all. I'm really glad you like it. I'll be honest. Since it's our first time sharing, I wanted to write something a little more mild. Something easy to digest, I suppose. Are you into ghosts, Yuri? Actually, the story isn't about a ghost at all, Bellamy.
Really?
You must have totally missed the point. Well, I suppose you did only glance over it after all. But remember that poets often express their own thoughts, feelings, and experiences in their work. They usually do more than tell a simple story or paint a picture. In this case, perhaps the subject of the poem is only being symbolically compared to a ghost, lingering in our last remaining place of comfort, unable to let go of the past, and soon to be left with nothing. That's a lot more solemn putting it that way. Yours was impressive too, so...
Nah.
If anything, I could probably learn it. Thing or two from you.
You think so?
Yeah, of course. You know, it was really nervous doing all this, but in the end I enjoyed it. I'm going to keep doing my best for you, Bellamy.
Me too.
Who should I show my poem to next? Monica.
Hi, Bellamy. Having a good time so far?
No, not really.
Oh, yeah. Good, glad to hear it. By the way, since you're new and everything, if you ever have any suggestions for the club, like new activities or things we can do better, I'm always listening. Don't be afraid to bring things up, okay?
Alright, I'll keep that in mind.
Of course, I'll be afraid to bring things up. I'm much better off just going with the flow until I'm more settled in. Anyway, want to share your poem with me?
It's kind of embarrassing, but I guess I have to.
Haha! Don't worry, Bellamy. We're all a little embarrassed today, you know?
But it's that sort of barrier that we'll all learn to get past soon.
Yeah, that's true.
I hand Monica my poem.
Great job, Bellamy.
I was going to ooh in my head while reading it.
What?
It's really metaphorical.
I'm not sure why, but I didn't expect you to go for something so deep. I guess I underestimated you. It's easiest for me to keep everyone's expectations low. That way, it always counts when I put in some effort. Haha, that's not very fair. Well, I guess it worked anyway. You know that Yuri likes this kind of writing, right? Writing that's full of imagery and symbolism. Unlike Sayori, who likes simple and direct words to describe happiness and sadness, Yuri likes it when readers are left to derive their own meaning out of it. It's very challenging to write like that effectively. Both allowing people to get something out of it just by feel or letting them deeply analyze all of the nuances. It can take years of practice, which I'm assuming Yuri has at this point. I never really asked though. I'm sure I'm nowhere near her level yet. Don't worry so much about it. You do your own thing. Just keep exploring and learn by trying new things. I'm sure I'll end up trying different things a lot.
Oh. It could take a while before I feel comfortable doing this.
That's okay. I'd love to see you try new things. That's the best way to find the kind of style that suits you. Everyone else might be a little biased towards their own kind of styles, but I'll always help you find what suits you the most. So don't force yourself to write the way everyone else wants you to write. It's not like you have to worry about impressing them or anything. Ha ha ha! Ha 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 ha. Anyway, do you want to read my poem now? Don't worry, I'm not very good. You sound pretty confident for someone who claims to be not very good. Well, that's because I hate to sound confident. That doesn't mean I always feel that way, you know? I see. Well, let's read it. The hole in the wall. It couldn't have been me. See the direction the sparkle protrudes? A noisy neighbor, an angry boyfriend? I'll never know. I wasn't home. I peer inside for a clue. No, I can't see. I reel, blind, like a film left out in the sun. But it's too late. My retinas. Already scorched with a permanent copy of the meaningless image. It's just a little hole. It wasn't too bright. It was too deep, stretching forever into everything. A hole of infinite choices. I realize now that I wasn't looking in, I was looking out, and he on the other side was looking in. Jeez. So what do you think? Gesley Viathan, what's up? Too deep. I actually like that poem.
Sorry, I'm not really the right person to ask for feedback.
It's okay. That kind of style has gotten very popular nowadays. That is, a lot of poems have been putting emphasis on the timing of between words and lines. When performed out loud, it can be really powerful. What was the inspiration behind this one?
Ow.
Well, I'm not sure if I know how to put it. I guess you could say that I had some kind of epiphany recently.
It's been influencing my poems a bit. Epiphany?
Yeah, something like that. I'm kind of nervous to talk about deep stuff like that because it's kind of coming on strongly. Maybe after everyone is better friends with each other. Anyway, here's Monica's writing tip of the day. Sometimes when you're writing a poem or a story, your brain gets too fixated on a specific point. If you try so hard to make it perfect, then you'll never make any progress. Just force yourself to get something down on the paper and tidy it up later. Another way to think about it is this. If you keep your pen in the same spot for too long, you'll just get a big dark puddle of ink. So just move your hand and go with the flow. That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Who should I show my poem to next? Natsuki. Bellamy, if you're not going to take this clip seriously, then go home. What? Harsh? What, you expect me to believe that you actually put effort into this? Do you think I'm stupid? Wow! I'm not a writer. Maybe it's not very good, but yeah, I did put in effort. We all start somewhere, right? If you're still proud of the first poem you ever wrote, then I'd like to read it. Painful to think about? Fine. Well, sorry. You'll get better anyway. I tell you what to improve it, but you're better off just trying again. Fair enough. Well, to each his own, I guess. Anyway, I guess I gotta share mine now. Knowing you, you'll probably think it's stupid. Eagles can fly, monkeys can climb, crickets can leap, horses can race. Owls can seek, cheetahs can run, eagles can fly, people can try. That's about it. Yeah, I told you that you weren't gonna like it.
I like it.
What? Just be honest. I am. What kind of poem is that? Why are you so convinced that I wouldn't like it? That is like the best poem. That was great, wasn't it? Look how cute she is with that poem. Because everyone in high school thinks that writing has to be all sophisticated and stuff. So people don't even take my writing seriously. But it isn't the point of poems for people to express themselves. Your writing style wouldn't make your message any less valid. Yes, exactly! I like when it's easy to read, but it hits you hard. Yeah! Like in this poem. Seeing everyone around me do great things can be really disheartening. So I decided to write about it. Yeah, I understand. But the other nice thing about simple writing is that it puts more weight on the wordplay. Like I set up for a rhyme at the end, but then made it fall flat on purpose. It helps bring out the feeling in the last line. So you did. I guess more went into it than I realized. That's what it means to be a pro! Of course. I'm glad you learned something. Didn't expect that from the youngest one here, did you? Yeah, I guess not. I decided to humor her with that last comment. I don't really care how old everyone is, but if Natsuki is feeling proud, then I won't take that away from her. Jeez. Who should I show? I don't want to show it to her. Okay. This is a good poem, Bellamy. Are you sure it's your first time? Of course. It's not that good. Am I the kind of guy who'd be writing poems in his spare time? I guess you're right. But that's why it impressed me. Well, to be honest, I was afraid that you wouldn't do it seriously. Or that you wouldn't write at all. I'm really happy just that you wrote one. It just reminds me of how you were really part of the club now. Not to mention the fact that I'm standing in front of you in the club room. Or, well, of course. I'm not really into it yet, but that doesn't mean I'll break my promise. See? It's like I said before, Bellamy. Deep down, you're not selfish at all, you know? Trying new things like this for other people? That's something that only really good people can do. Thanks, Sayori. I'm not sure if Sayori sees the full picture of my motive here. Then again, I can't deny that she's part of the reason I joined, knowing how much this means to her and all. Yeah. And I'm gonna make sure you have lots of fun here, okay? That would be my way of thanking you. Alright, I'm going to hold you to that then. Yay! Now you read my poem too, right? Don't worry, I'm really bad at this. Hehehe. We'll see about that. Dear Sunshine, the way you glow through my blinds in the morning, it makes me feel like you missed me. Kissing my forehead to help me out of bed, making me rub the sleepy from my eyes. Are you asking me to come out and play? Are you trusting me to wish away a rainy day? I look above, the sky is blue. It's a secret, but I trust you too. If it wasn't for you, I could sleep forever, but I'm not mad. I want breakfast. Fairy, this is just a guess, but did you wait until this morning to write this?
No.
Just a little bit? You can't answer just a little bit to a yes or no question. I forgot to do it last night. But at least that makes me feel a little bit better about myself. Don't be mean. I still tried my best. Ah, yeah. I didn't mean to say it was a bad poem. It came out nice, or how should I put it? It sounded just like you.
Really?
Yeah. Especially that last line. I made eggs and toast. Even though you were late to school? It's bad to skip breakfast. I get all cranky. Well, I guess there's no point in arguing. Anyway, thanks for showing me. Hehehe. This was so much fun. Monica's the best. Ah, yeah. But next time I won't forget. And I'm gonna write the best poem ever. Well, I guess I look forward to it. You cannot skip breakfast. Breakfast is very important. You need the learning advice of the day. Eat your food. I guess that's everyone. I glance around the room. That was a little more stressful than I anticipated. It's as if everyone is judging me for my mediocre writing abilities. Even if they're just being nice, there's no way my poems can stand up to theirs. This is a literature club after all. Can't skip Doki Doki either. I guess that's what I ended up getting myself into. Across the room, Sayuri and Monika are happily chatting. My eyes land on Yuri and Natsuki. They gingerly exchange sheets of paper, sharing their respective poems. As they read in tandem, I watch each of their expressions change. Natsuki's eyebrows furrow in frustration. Meanwhile, Yuri smiles sadly. What's with this language? Eh? Did you say something?
Oh, it's nothing.
Natsuki dismissively returns the poem to the desk with one hand. I guess you could say it's fancy.
Thanks.
Yours is cute.
Cute?
Did you completely miss the symbolism or something? It's clearly about the feeling of giving up. How can that be cute?
I know that. I just meant the language, I guess. I was trying to say something nice.
Eh? You mean you have to try that hard to come up with something nice to say? Thanks, but it really didn't come out nice at all.
Well, I do have a couple of suggestions.
If I was looking for suggestions, I would have asked someone who actually liked it. Which people did, by the way. My god, there's gonna be a fight! Hair pulling!
Sayori liked it, and Bellamy did too. So based on that,
I'll gladly give you some suggestions of my own.
First of all...
Excuse me. I appreciate the offer, but I've spent a long time establishing my writing style. I don't expect it to change anytime soon, unless of course I come across something particularly inspiring.
Girl, fight!
Exactly. Hair pulling and, you know, scratching. It's coming. How's it going? Which I haven't yet.
Oh, shoot.
Meh. And Bellamy liked my poem too, you know.
He even told me he was impressed by it.
Natsuki suddenly stands up.
Oh?
I didn't realize you were so invested in trying to impress our new member, Yuri.
Oh, it's starting.
That's not what I...
You're just...
Yuri stands up as well. Maybe you're just jealous that Bellamy appreciates my advice more than he appreciated yours.
Huh?
And how do you know he didn't appreciate my advice more? Are you that full of yourself?
No. If I was full of myself, I would deliberately go out of my way to make everything I do overly cutesy.
Is everyone okay?
Well, you know what? I wasn't the one whose boobs magically grew a size bigger as soon as Bellamy started showing up.
Natsuki! Natsuki, that's a little... This doesn't involve you!
I don't like fighting, guys.
Suddenly, both girls turned towards me as if they just noticed I was standing there.
Cat fight! Cat fight!
Bellamy?
She's just trying to make me look bad.
That's not true.
Oh god.
She started it.
Oh god.
If she could just get over herself and learn to appreciate that simple writing is more effective, then this wouldn't have happened in the first place. What's the point of making your poems all convoluted for no reason?
The meaning should just jump out of the reader and not force them to have to figure it out.
Help me explain that to her, Bellamy.
Wait! There's a reason we have so many deep and expressive words in our language. It's the only way to convey complex feelings and meanings the most effectively. Avoiding them is not only unnecessarily limiting yourself, but it's also a waste.
You understand that, right, Bellamy?
Well? How did I get dragged to do this in the first place?
It's not like I know anything about writing, but whoever I agree with, they'll probably think more highly of me.
Oh god, no, I gotta choose! No!
What? I am totally going with Yuri.
Natsuki,
you're right that I liked your poem.
See?
Wait. That's not an excuse for you to be so mean. You shouldn't pick a fight just because someone's opinion is different.
That's not what happened at all. Yuri wouldn't even take my poem seriously.
I understand. Yuri?
Eh?
You're a seriously talented writer. It's no secret that I was impressed.
Well, that's...
But here's the thing. No matter how simple or refined someone's writing style is, they're still putting feelings into it, and it becomes something really personal. That's why Natsuki felt threatened when you said her poem was cute.
I see. I didn't notice that I'm sorry.
Aw. But Natsuki, you took it way too far. Yuri means well, and if you just told her how you felt, then this wouldn't have happened in the first place. Are you kidding? That's exactly what I did. It was her that... Natsuki, I think that's enough. You both said things that you didn't mean. Yuri apologized, don't you think you should too? Natsuki clenches her fists. In the end, nobody has taken her side. She's trapped. At this point, being defiant only because she can't handle the pressure, I end up even feeling bad for her.
Sometimes when I'm hurt, it helps to take a walk and clear my head.
Sayori, she doesn't need to. You know what? I'm going to do that. It'll spare me from having to look up at all of your faces right now. Without warning, Natsuki snatches her own poem up from the desk and storms out. On her way out, she crumples up the poem with her hands and throws it in the trash. There was no hair pulling also. Like, God.
Sad, sad.
Chur, Monica, chur, what's up? How's it going? Mizzil, welcome, welcome. She really didn't need to do that. I look across the room. Yuri has her chin buried in her hands while she stares down at her desk. Crisis averted. For now. I gingerly approach her and sit in the adjacent chair.
Sigh. Everything alright? I'm so embarrassed. I can't believe I acted like that.
You probably hate me now. No, Yuri. How could anyone not have gotten frustrated after being treated like that? You handled it as well as anyone could. I don't think any less of you.
Well, alright, I believe you.
Thanks, Bellamy. You're too kind. I'm thankful to have you a part of this club now. Or it's nothing? Welcome back to teenage life, yeah. One more thing. That one thing that Natsuki said about, you know, I would never do anything so shameful. So, eh? What thing did Natsuki say?
Well, never mind that. I'm going to make some tea.
Good idea. Make enough for more than one person, okay?
Yeah.
Did this stuff actually happen in teenage life? Okay, everyone. It's just about time for us to leave. How did y'all feel about sharing poems?
It was a lot of fun.
Well, I'd say it was worth it. It was alright, mostly. Bellamy, how about you? Yeah, I'd say the same. It was a neat thing to talk about with everyone.
Awesome!
In that case, we'll do the same thing tomorrow. And maybe you learn something from your friends too. So your poems will turn out even better. It's based on a true story? I did learn. Oh my god. That's not fair. I want to see my poem.
Bellamy, ready to walk home?
Sure, let's go. What do you mean? You know, between Yuri and Natsuki, does that kind of thing happen often? No. That's really the first time I've seen them fight like that. I promise they're both wonderful people. You don't hate them, do you? No, I don't hate them. I just wanted your opinion, that's all. I can see why they'd make good friends with you.
Phew. You know, Bellamy, it's nice that I get to spend time with you in the club, but I think seeing you get along with everyone
is what makes me the happiest. And I think everyone really likes you too.
That's... Hehehe.
Every day is going to be so fun.
Sigh. It looks like Sayori still hasn't caught on to the kind of situation I'm in. Sure, being friends with everyone is nice, but does it really need to stop there?
Well, we'll just have to see what the future holds, Sayori. I pass Sayori on the shoulder. I said that more to myself than to her, but it's easy to use Sayori as an internal monologue sometimes. Okay. Yeah. Let's do this. Oh god, I gotta write another poem?
Extreme mega test.
It'd be nice if we could actually just see our own.